my second oldest son, Cal, calls me up and says, "Dad, you want to come to this AGC meeting, this convention?" I said, "Why?" "Well, we have good meals and drinks, and Glenn Campbell's going to be there." I said, "Really?" "I've been walking these streets
so long." Who am I married to? Well, let's see. Probably the most unique man in the world. Like a rhinestone
cowboy. Well, I was born on a farm in Idaho. Kids were taught to work hard, not expect anything given to them. I guess that's the way I started out. I was lucky enough to be one of the best boxers they had produced in a long while, so I got a scholarship at the University of Idaho. I graduated in civil engineering, and from then I started an engineering company. I started seeing some of the contractors I had worked for and found out that I knew more than they did about building things. We didn't plan a whole lot, we just worked hard, and lucky enough to have seven boys. I mean, who couldn't be successful in construction if they had seven boys?
Unfortunately, he chickened out and didn't give me a daughter, but they all came later.
Well, in the first place, it's kind of tough to get seven great sons without a pretty good wife to help you out there. My wife's always been a hard worker and done a great job. My boys learn how to use a shovel when they're big enough to hold one. And it wasn't long before they could pound nails, and as they got older, they could build forms, pour concrete. They're all trying to outdo each other in whatever you try to do, whether it's digging holes or a shovel or riding horses. I didn't spoil them. We enjoyed what we were doing. It was easy when you do it that way.
In 1975, at age 45, Ralph began his construction company by handing his boys Guy, Con, and Todd a shovel. Ralph turned their weekly allowance into a billable return as they embarked on their first bridge project, a box culvert under State Street in Sandy, Utah. Within 10 years, RLW Construction revenues grew from $500,000 to $17 million. Small street improvements grew into large-scale highway and bridge projects. Today, revenues exceed $300 million annually, and their work spans 10 states with divisions in heavy highway, deep foundation, concrete batching, and commercial industrial concrete. There is an aesthetic side to Ralph's legacy that impresses drivers daily as they pass by the 200 structural concrete art murals displayed across Utah's highways and byways. Pioneered by his son Todd, every design and installation detail is performed by their own crew. Bridge work is the true hallmark of Ralph's legacy, dotting the Utah construction landscape. It was Ralph who pioneered Utah's first ever accelerated bridge construction with an overnight bridge installation at 4500 South and I-215. RLW is the reputable leader in the ABC industry, with over 26 bridges placed without error or delay. Ralph began Wadsworth Development Group in 1996. They've gone on to perform development work across 12 states, developing over $1 billion worth of commercial real estate. Ralph L. Wadsworth's impact on the construction industry is showcased across Utah with over 650 traffic and pedestrian structures and many other landmark projects that have intersected with each of our lives. Ralph takes pride in the hard work ethic, respect, and grit found in the Utah-based workforce that has made all of this possible.
In Utah, we have workers and people that are a heck of a lot better than most of the United States, I can tell you that. They know how to work, they know what the law is, they respect each other. Having seven sons and having two of them that will bid against you on big jobs like I have in the past 20 years. But the good thing about it is they were all home for Thanksgiving dinner and Christmas.
He's such a hard worker and a genuine giving person. Did that bridge up above us that he just about built all by himself with some of the boys' help, and that was quite a project.
The Draper Swinging Bridge, designed and built by Ralph, is a lasting symbol of his servant heart. Among other charities his company has contributed to, Ralph is proud of the National Guard Charitable Trust Fund, which he started over 10 years ago. RLW hosts a 5K run and silent auction to raise funds that provide financial aid for families of soldiers and officers sent abroad. Ralph and his wife Peggy also spearheaded an effort to fund and build a new facility for the Sandy Club, a safe place for boys and girls.
It's my hope that this next generation of builders will follow men like Ralph and what they've accomplished in their time and dedicated their lives to, a lot of them.
I just want to thank my sons and the workers that work for me. I just can't say enough for they deserve this award. There's no doubt about that.
The AGC is proud to honor Ralph L. Wadsworth with the Eric W. Ryberg Award for excellence and dedication in service to the general contracting industry of Utah.